Hello everyone, welcome back to another Go opening video. Today I would like to present you a very good game between Yutayama and Choyu. Both are 9P professional players from Japan. So today we'll cover their opening as well. Yutayama is playing as black and Choyu is playing as white. Black now approaches from the inside. White decides to counter approach. So a lot of times in professional games, you'll see players not responding passively. So no one can really criticize you for playing a local Joseki move, but for professional players, the idea of not following the other player's intention is a very important concept. And that shows itself at move 6. Black kicks, white extends, and then black hop out, and then white plays the most standard Joseki. Now black, since white did not respond, black decided a double approach to gain a local advantage against white's corner. So this is a kind of rare Joseki. So I covered some parts of this Joseki, where we just need to attach on one side. This is covered in my Joseki lectures. So today I would like to, I guess, give you guys a little bit of general knowledge of how to deal with this kind of approach. Most players have problem with it. Back in the old days, I think there's one variation like this, where black goes in the corner, white cuts over here, black pulls back, and white extends out. This is like a territory versus influence. I personally prefer black, obviously, because I think it is just favorable for black in this position. Black has a lot of territory, and then black white seems a little bit concentrated, over concentrated. But back then this was a Joseki, and AI does not seem to like it either. So these days the correct Joseki is for white to extend at f6. So against this move, black has few main variations, but I want to cover like the very basics since we have other stuff to cover as well. The first thing is, what if black hop into the corner? How, as white, can you deal with this? Well, the correct way for you to deal with this is to block here. Black is forced to pull the stone back, and all we need to do is to keep pushing. When black blocks, we can just hane it here. Black is going to follow up with this move. Black can also decide to fix this cutting point, in which case we can just make a tiger's mouth, and this is an equal position. White is working on the top side and black's working on the right side. Nothing wrong with this. Black can also choose to not give up the corner, and we will play the tiger's mouth still. When black ataris, black needs atari here. So if black connects, the follow-up move is really big. It destroys black's corner territory, but also gives white very nice ice space. So this group becomes a lot stronger than before. It looks like it's a first line move, but it's extremely important. And it's one of those exceptions where a first line move is very big in this early in the game. All right, so most cases your opponent needs atari here. If not, it would be inaccuracy. I wouldn't say a mistake, but the correct and accurate move is for black to follow up with this atari. So here white has two choices. If the ladder works for you, you can directly ladder the stone, and this is a slightly better position for white. But in this game, the ladder clearly does not work. If you read it out, this stone is like as if we have a stone over here. So that's obviously not going to work for white. So since the ladder doesn't work, what you can do is to turn on top, threaten the double atari, black connects. We can keep expanding ourselves on top and reducing black on the bottom. So black pretty much has no way to compete against white for moyo development. He pretty much has to go ahead and just reduce whatever MOYO you have. And this is pretty much a equal position moving on. This is a very standard Joseki as well. So that's a little bit about what happens when Black hops in the corner. Before that, I want to just say that at this point, you might be wondering why Black does just harness from the outside. Why can't Black get aggressive? Well, this is actually a legit variation. It's just not as great. Like, it's probably like 2% lower in terms of win rate against the main variation. So here, White absolutely needs a cut. There's a push here, so Black needs to prevent this. And all White needs to do is just a crawl on the third line twice and then make a small knight. This is also a equal position. I personally really like White because I think it's very territory focused for White. And then Black needs to manage the influence with a remaining stone at f5. So if you like territory, this is definitely a good position for you as White. So that's how you deal with Black's aggression. You can just dodge this very easily. That's why most players would just play from the outside, in which case we'll extend out. Today, the two players play out the second main variation is for Black to push on top. This is a slightly more complicated. So by pushing here, there's a very serious weakness at e5. And then White needs to fix with the shape move, right? White absolutely does not want to fix like this because it's just way too ugly. It's an empty triangle. So the shape for this kind of move is obviously to play the attach to d6, in which case Black needs to hane here, focusing on the outside. And then White needs to fix this stone because this stone is very serious. If you don't play anything, Black can enclose White inside, and this is very serious stuff. So what Black can do are two variations. One is to play the tiger's mouth here, and then this is followed up by so if White plays here, Black needs to follow up by haneing here. White needs to atari because White has no choice. And when Black ataris here, White can just sacrifice the two stones here and then make an exchange. So the exchange in this case looks a little bit scary for White because Black's gaining a huge influence on the outside. But we cannot underestimate the amount of territory that White is able to gain here. This is a lot of territory, and then White gets the sente. So this is a slightly favorable position for White, actually. It is hard to manage, but it's definitely still very playable for White. The other variation is for White to hane here, which is pretty much the same. It's pretty much the same variation because Black's gonna cut and then White ataris, and we're back to the same thing, right? We're back to the same variation. Why can't White play something like this? If you play here, I can just extend. This exchange doesn't do anything except hurting the c7 stone, right? This is not really a great idea for White here. So let's say if you keep pushing, the problem is it doesn't accomplish anything. So Black can pretty much, well, first of all, Black can just capture everything here, right? Black can just capture your stones first. Black can probably also extend out. So this is also, can Black extend out here? So Black can probably just follow up with this kind of variation. And this is more than enough for Black just to capture the stone here. That's why White does not want atari here. White absolutely needs atari in this direction. So today, both players, the two players have played out a new variation, in which case White decided to connect at d5. This is in terms of percentage win rate, this is a lot worse than Atari at c5. But I guess it made sense to the white player, Chou Yu. And then, and probably it's because at the time he was playing this game, AI was not as developed as it is today. That's why he chose this variation. It doesn't really affect the win or loss because white is still at about 55% win rate. So the follow-up, black Ataris, white has to extend, black connects, white turns here, and then black blocks. And then here is what I want you guys to kind of appreciate, is that the next move is for white to cut here. So before we go back and fix our problems, so we know that this b6 is must play move. If you don't play this move, black blocks, and then this is all dead. So before you do that, make sure you create weaknesses for your opponent. It's a very important concept in the game of Go. That is this idea of being very proactive. Against this move, black could have extended out at here, and then white goes back and fix, and then probably black is going to connect over here, and this is more or less equal position. However, the black player is currently the number one player in Japan and then extremely good at fighting. So in the actual game, he decided to Atari on top, which is really aggressive. When white gets out, black keeps going. Now white needs to go back and fix the problem over here. Black Ataris, white turns, the ladder is working. So now the next move, black decided to play the Kosumi here, which is a very nice shape move. So a lot of times, a lot of viewers would probably just Atari, and then play a Tiger's Mouth. This is perfectly understandable. It's not a big deal if you play it this way, but I guess I won't go into the theory of what's going on. I just really want you to learn by watching the pros. Their understanding of shapes and their understanding of flow when it comes to a fight. That is this Kosumi here. And then white follows up with a very nice looking Kosumi as well. So both players seem to understand the same thing about shapes when it comes to fight. But obviously I think as long as you get the ideas right, even if you extend here, I guess it's not a big deal, right? If you extend here, black is pretty much forced to protect the weakness. And then you can Kosumi all you want, right? So, but instead, white decided to also play Kosumi to get himself out. Next move, black plays very aggressively, trying to enclose white inside. White plays over here. So this is very important. So today I covered a little bit about the Joseki here, but I also want to cover some ideas of fight. So when you fight, you always want to play very aggressively as long as the reading works, right? So white does not want to cut over here immediately because it just currently does not work. The reason it doesn't work is because, well, let's say black Atari is here. You're forced to extend, then what if black plays here? There's a ladder. If you fix this, I can Atari here. And then when you connect, I can Atari, and then that's game over. So these are based on calculations. And if white just hops out like this, there's already this problem. It does not work. Oh, it works right now, right? So white cannot even hop out right now. So the correct shape is what Chou Yu played, is to Kosumi once again. This looks very dangerous, but actually tactically it works, because at this point there's no way for black to catch white. So the Kosumi is very nice, and now black Hane is on top, just trying trying his best to just immediately kill White Inside. The next move, White Harness, Black Ataris, and then we see the next move, super aggressive. See, as long as, you know, the outside is not falling apart, we try to put max pressure on our opponent, which is an excellent idea. White squeezes here. So if White plays the Hane here, it's also a variation. So Black currently has this thing that works. White cannot connect. White has to double Atari here. And then Black captures and White captures. And then Black extends. This is probably also an equal position. Black is able to connect everything with points. And then White is able to gain a very strong outside. But in the actual game, White decided to not give up the three stones here. Rather, he just squeezes here. When Black connects, the next move, White counterattacks by trying to kill Black's four stones here. The next move, Black just does all these aggressive moves to try to absolutely kill White. So this move requires a lot of calculations, right? You cannot play this move without any sort of thinking, because the next move, when Black plays here, you only have two liberties. But Choyu is a 9P professional. He reads things out, and then he plays the Hane here. Next move, Black Ataris, White connects. So it looks very exciting. It looks like someone's about to resign. But actually, there's no way for Black to catch White. If you play here, White is gonna play here. If you connect, White's gonna get out, and actually it's Black who is falling apart. So looks like White is almost dead, but it's actually not. The next move, Black needs to connect here. And now when White cuts, this is very interesting. When White cuts here, this still is not working. You cannot fill in here, but if you fill in from here, that's not a problem. Well, not only it's not a problem, in fact, it's game over for Black, right? Because Black got killed inside. So when White cuts over here, Black decides to flip Atari here. So here, White has to be very careful when it comes to reading because of how dangerous the situation is. If White just extend, that's immediately game over because Black has a Tsuji here. When White connects, Black connects. When White turns, Black turns. And then that's game over right here. So White cannot extend. Instead, White decided to cut over here. This actually will capture, this is actually going to capture Black, because if Black plays here, White extends out. It looks like White is dead, but actually when you examine it, it's Black who's dead, right? You cannot fill in here. You cannot fill in here, here. And if you take here, I can just capture you from behind. So very exciting situation where, you know, both players only have two liberties on everything. So at this point, when this happens, Black decided to capture, and then White connects, and then Black blocks the outside. And this is the kind of the end of the opening. What happens here next is that White Ataris, Black connects, then White decided to play somewhere else because Black is already captured. So White is able to gain a very huge corner. This corner is probably about almost 40 points. And then White gets the Sente to play on the outside. Black is also doing fine. He's slightly worse position, but he's doing okay because Black has a very strong Moyo on the outside. The next move, Black connects. This is a Sente. White needs to go back and fix the Liberty. And then we can see how strong Black is over here, right? This is just tremendous strength. And then this guy is probably gonna be under very fierce attack later on. So this is the sort of the opening I want to present to you today. We covered some very concrete knowledge about the double approach, except it's a high approach, not the normal low approach. I introduced you two main variations. I also I didn't really talk too much about the fights and then all the detailed variations here, but I showed you how professional players fight. Sometimes they get into like a super exciting fight where you think that one of them is gonna get destroyed, but actually the game keeps going. This happens all the time in professional games. So just to show you like how accurate at this point the reading of white has to be to play this move, because when black plays here, this looks so dangerous for white, right? But eventually white is able to read everything out and then just actually capture white while giving black the compensation of controlling the outside. So very neat opening. There was not really too much Joseki is happening. There's like a very traditional Joseki happening, and then boom, we just go straight into a very fierce fight. So very cool game. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys next time.